Hello, everybody. My name is Will Gamer, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. In the last part, we found this shotgun messiah, and we waited through the night till it turned daytime before we started basically breaking stuff in order to search everything. So as soon as I start hitting these, they'll probably start breaking that down, and we'll have to deal with them. But I really want to check out what's in these boxes. So I'm just going to grab these. And I also... So there's a lot of moaning last night. I also heard a bear. That's interesting. Surprisingly, they're not trying to break in yet, but... we'll see. Anyway, so... also... ooh! Okay, I actually already have this, but I'll read it. Also, off-screen, I went and upgraded some skills. I accidentally upgraded to Fast Eddie, because I mistook it for Quality Joe for some reason. But I upgraded my scavenging to 30 and upgraded Quality Joe to level 2. So now every time I find something, it should be of a lot better quality. That's kind of the idea of that. Alright, so let's go around and look around for any crates that we haven't yet opened. Hopefully we'll find some good stuff. I hear you, bear. I guess I kind of already did look through everything. Kind of sucked that those crates in the other room didn't have... okay, this one I haven't opened yet. Alright, yep, I'm being hunted. They're gonna start coming in here pretty soon, as soon as they figure out how to get in here. Take that. Yes, I see you there. Apparently that's a crawler or a spider kind of dude. Whatever. Alright, let's see. Did I check these? I did. Alright, looks like the shotgun messiah is pretty much depleted. Unfortunately, didn't get as much stuff as I may have wanted. So we'll have to come back here and... oh wait, yeah, that's right. There's a gun safe here. I almost forgot. I'm gonna close that door. Shh. Silence! Stupid zombies. Anyway. Hopefully we'll find something good in here. Also, I'm planning on going to a crack-a-book. Oh yeah, they're breaking stuff out there. They're gonna try to get in. We'll deal with that when we get there. Cool. Alright, so looks like we got everything we need. We're gonna go ahead and grab all the stuff that we're gonna take back with us to the main base. Yeah. Yeah, I know, zombies, I know. You're bored. You're really bored out there. You really want to eat some of my brains. I will try my best not to let that happen. Okay, so let's see. I have a good one of these already, so I can do that. 44 Magnum parts, not bad. I already have a pistol grip, so we can get rid of that one. Hunting rifle parts, that's probably better than the one I currently have. Let's see here. Assemble... oh yeah, it's way better. There we go. Alright, close that. And we'll scrap this. That's pretty cool. So, yeah. So apparently in Alpha 15, whenever that comes out, you can sell the gun parts that you don't use, and apparently gun parts are really expensive. So don't throw those away. Jesus, shut up. Alright, I can actually assemble part of the shotgun. I just don't have a receiver, but I will keep that together so it saves me some space. Pistol parts. How's my pistol doing? Unfortunately, I can't. Yeah, I'm gonna save this. That's still very good. This is still very good. I just need to find a pistol schematic so I can actually use them. Alright, anything else I need from here? I'll take these. Alright, let's freaking go. Time to get out of this place. Alright, I need to... well, before I just go, I need to come up with a plan of where I want to go next. I don't know. I'll probably just run around the town. Maybe find something interesting. Anyway, let's get out of here. Any bad zombies nearby? Probably some dogs. Probably some cops. Oh, boy. I really don't know if I should have come here. Yeah, I don't know. I think I'm going to go to the Crack-A-Book, so I'm going to actually go ahead and leave town. Now we're going to go back to that one Crack-A-Book, and hopefully all the stuff we found there a long time ago has respawned, and we'll maybe find some pistol schematics. But also, mainly, I want to drop off a lot of this gear I found at the main base. That's the main thing I want to do. Okay. So, the Crack-A-Book was over here, so we are going to put a waypoint there, and we're gonna go. We're gonna go straight there. Hopefully we'll find something good. Yeah. Also, I also decided that I don't want to waste too much time when recording on meaningless tasks like cutting down trees or mining. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pause the video, and then whenever the next significant thing I do, whether that is looting, whether that is fighting some zombies along the way, then I will start recording again. But as far as regular menial task of just simply running from point A to point B, I will have the video paused and resume. So anyway, I will see you guys in a second. Alright guys, welcome back. I just found a zombie dog. Okay. Yeah, didn't want you to miss out on that exciting thing. Jeez. Exciting to me as well. Oh boy. Okay. So far, I've just collected some feathers from some nests down there. I avoided the zombies along the way, so not much really happened on the way here. Another burning zombie. Also running out of a lot of stamina pretty quickly. But that's okay. Anyway, we're almost there to the Crack-A-Book, so might as well continue recording. Also, I won't be stopping the episodes at any particular points from now on. I'll actually just record until I get to like 20 minutes of footage, and then I'll call that an episode at whatever point I end up being at. So, yeah, so at some times I may actually continue recording even after the night of the day. So, yeah, there won't be any particularly hard stops. I might as well drink a beer since I'm getting really exhausted. Alright. Okay. Nice buzz. There we go. Anyway, so yeah, a lot of good responses on the new thumbnails that I made. I'm glad you guys really enjoy it. Yeah. I think the new thumbnail design is a quite an upgrade from what I've been doing, which was just making one thumbnail and then just keep using that one over and over again. This time, at least, the thumbnails are different for each episode, which I think is a lot better, more clickable. Anyway, at least I thought I was almost there. Yeah, we're almost there. Okay. Let's just keep going. Actually, anything in the stump? Get some more parts. Hunting rifle parts. I already have better ones, so I'll scrap that. Okay, let's keep on going. I want to get to that Crack-A-Book, and then after that we'll do whatever. But the main thing I want to do is to get there and hopefully find some... Oh! Hello, bear. Hopefully find some pistol schematics. That's the number one thing. Alright, cool. We're almost there. Yeah. Have I been to the roof of this? I probably haven't. Yeah, I don't think I did. I'm gonna go up there right now, see what I find. Alright, I've got a corpse. Haven't checked it. Let's see, any packs up here? Doesn't look like it. Oh, nope, there's one. Okay, hunting rifle stock. What's mine right now? Mine's way better. So I don't need that. I could scrap this. Alright. Any zombies around here? No. Kind of difficult to find the ladder, although jumping on the dumpster works just as well. Alright, doesn't look like any zombies came by since I left, although we'll find out in a second. Oh, I guess we're good. Awesome, how did I get in here the first time? Oh yeah, through the window. Through the window! Through the wall! Oh yeah, so in Alpha 15, those coins will actually be worth money. And it looks like, unfortunately, nothing respawned. That kind of sucks. Let's break into this door. We haven't been in here yet. Yeah, so I have it set to respond every 5 days. And, oh, first aid kit. At least that's something. So the last time I came here was day 5, so maybe tomorrow all this stuff will respawn. Oh, I apparently haven't checked the beverage coolers, so that's important. Nothing in that refrigerator. Haven't checked these cabinets. See what's inside. Okay, I guess we'll take those. And nothing there. Anything in the back room? Just some glue. Oh, wait. Haven't been in here. There might be a safe. I'll check it out real quick. Is there a safe? There is a safe. Okay. So this is definitely worth coming back for. Yeah, it doesn't sound like there's any zombies around, so we're safe to do this. That's neat. Alright, sorry this sometimes takes a while to actually do things like this, but it's a necessary evil. Until I get better tools. So we found some leather leg schematics, which I already have unlocked, but at least that'll be there for the next time I come by. Alright, nothing in there, nothing there. Is there another safe in here? Nope, just cabinets. Okay. Already checked that. That's nothing. Okay. Cool. So looks like we already exhausted this area to the best of our ability, so let's just get out of here. Alright, let's figure out where we want to go next. Alright, yeah, I don't have any areas that that probably respawned yet, unfortunately. So we are gonna go. Well, actually, main thing is head back to base. That's number one thing, because we have a lot of stuff in our inventory. We're pretty much full, so we need to drop off that stuff as soon as we can. So I'm gonna head over to the base, and I will be back with you in a second. All right, and we are back to the base. So. Let's see here, I have a repair kit somewhere, so maybe I can repair the pistol. So let's see, I have some right here. Can I repair the pistol even without the schematic is the question. It looks like the answer is no. I cannot repair it even though I have a repair kit. That kind of sucks. So I'm going to have to keep the pistol in here for now until we find the schematic for it. That kind of sucks. Alright, so all my gun parts are actually in here. Okay, put those away. And let's see, I'm just gonna put pretty much everything away from here because we don't need these. Keep the beer. I don't think I need to bring the glass jars yet. I still have plenty of water on me. I'll keep half of them here. Alright, put those away. Pistol grip, wrench. Got a bunch of feathers, so I need to make iron tips. That's what I need to do. So let's put on the forge. And I don't have any wood! Shit. Kinda need that. Kind of important. Alright, I'm gonna use plant fibers for now. That'll work. And that'll last for 2 minutes. Okay. So we're gonna make some iron arrowheads right here. We're out of iron, so we need to do this. And just let that cook for a while. Okay, got some more iron bars and forged steel. Great. We have a lot of gunpowder though. Don't have much for bullet casings or bullet tips, unfortunately. All right, a lot of things I need to do. A lot of things. All right, and let's see. Inventory is basically empty. I'm gonna put away the feathers for now. I don't need them on my body at the moment. All right, so this is gonna be our loadout for now. Cool. Alright, game plan. What is the game plan? I don't want to head back to town. That's very far away. Haven't done much going left. Yeah, there's not much for me to do except perhaps basically use this day for resources because, as you can see, the wall is still broken and we need to do a lot of repairing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video. And I'm gonna head over there. I'm gonna go get a whole bunch of wood. I'm gonna go get a whole bunch of iron, and then I will come back and do some repairs. So anyway, I will see you guys in a second. All right, I'm back. All right, so what I discovered is that actually, if you break down these giant rocks, you can actually just make them fall into a bunch of bags on the ground and pick up stone really fast. So instead of having to mine the whole thing, you can just break down the foundation of it and the top layer will fall down, and you can just pick up the rocks, like, really fast. Like, as you saw there, I gained, like, 150 rocks in a short period of time because of all the rocks that fell down. So, yeah, so as you can see, I did a whole lot of resource gaining. I gained a ton of wood, almost 4,000, and I gained over 1,000 stone and 100 iron just by the trees around here and this one giant rock that I just finished destroying right here. Alright, so I also want to get some more iron as well, and I might as well kill this zombie for funsies. I killed another zombie earlier, but she didn't have anything, so there was no point in even mentioning her anyway. Let's see what this decayed mother has. Hazmat mask, I guess I'll take that. Alright, so for now I'm gonna go mine this iron. Actually, you know what, I'll just mine it on camera real quick. It's no big deal. It's just a little bit anyway. I just want to get some iron, that's mainly it. Alright, looks like we are pretty much done getting resources. We got, well, it's only 134 iron, but although if you put it in the fort, that's about 500, so that's not too bad. So we have a ton of resources now. That's gonna be good to last us for a while. So anyway, I've been watching some other YouTubers play this game, try to get some ideas, you know, what to do for this channel. You know, sometimes you don't want to have to learn everything yourself. Sometimes you want to get all your ideas from other people. Well, not all of them, but, you know, sometimes it's good to get some inspiration. And so what I discovered is that one guy said that you shouldn't have any doors on the first floor, like, at all, because doors are a weak point. So what you want to have to do is just have walls around the building and no doors into the first floor at all. You have to have some sort of other means of getting up there, maybe by a ladder or some kind of different kind of stairs, maybe. Like, you know, maybe I can put, like, a thing connecting to the wall there, and then a ladder from that point onward, something like that. But not having any doors on the bottom floor is the main thing. Anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and make a ton of wooden frames, if I can find it real quick. There it is. Alright, I'm gonna make, just gonna make 100 of them. I have a ton of wood anyway, so anyway, we're gonna finish this wall as soon as possible. Where are the frames going? There they are. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and finish putting up this here so at least zombies don't walk in, because that would be rather annoying. And then after this, I'm gonna put a whole bunch of those spikes on the outside. Whatever, we do that. Okay. Gotta reinforce these. Alright, put some iron on them. Fortunately, this is going to take quite a bit of iron in order to do, sadly. Alright, so let's fill up the rest of the holes here. Want to reinforce this as much as possible. And then maybe I'll put some spikes around this area as well as the wall. Yeah, also they broke my stairs, but I can still jump up there, so whatever. That'll be another obstacle that the zombies can't really get through, because they probably can't jump onto that stair. Alright, so I got a ton of wood. Might as well put that in here. Burn the rest of the iron. Actually, I can split that, make it do double the work. Alright, so I need to make, how many feathers I had? 201 feathers, wow. I have been saving up. Alright, so 201. Apparently I can only make 85 for now because of the iron currently in the forge, so we'll just let it go ahead and make that for now. Alright. Let's see here. That's right, we have a sawed-off shotgun. We have one complete here, so we can try to compare parts. Maybe we'll find some better stuff here. Alright, so this one doesn't have anything better. This one, I just need to take the receiver. In fact, I'll just take everything off of it and then just scrap all the things I don't use. Alright, and then this guy. Assemble, put this in there, and that'll be completed. Nothing else I have is better than that, so we're gonna drop this. We're gonna scrap this and scrap that. Okay. Cool. Oh, apparently I accidentally picked up the stuff again. Just drop that real quick. Okay. So we got a sawed-off shotgun. We only have 17 rounds for it. I don't really want to waste them yet. Let's put away our resources in one of these chests here. There we go. Let's put them down here so we can easily find them. Apparently, I already had 1,000 stone in here. I guess I totally forgot I had that. But anyway, that's cool. I'll keep some wood on me for the arrows, actually, that I'm about to make. So let's see, we have 85, so we need 115. Can only make 92. All right, that's fine. Let's take some of the arrows that we have currently right now, and let's make some iron arrows. I don't think I can make a crossbow yet, right? No, not yet. I haven't learned that. So let's go ahead and make all the iron arrows we can. All right, so let's see here. All right, so that's going to do it for this episode. Sorry, too much didn't really happen. We did go check out some more stuff in the Shotgun Messiah. But the next part, we will definitely go look around some more area and all that good stuff. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Really do hope you enjoyed. And please don't forget to always stay classy, sexy, and overall awesome. This is Will Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time.